me. Want to rest up a while, friend?
Hello, boy.
So what brings you to these parts? Well, I'm glad of the company, if I'm honest. The past 6 months or so, I ain't been around many people. Regular folks, at least. Ain't sure if you heard of a group called the Shalonians? I guess you could call it a religion. Obsessed with turtles, which maybe should have struck me stranger sooner. I know! You wouldn't believe it! Folk always say I'm too trusting. I mean, I don't know you from Adam, and here you are sitting at my fire. Anyway, I'm more or less handing my life over to them. I met a very persuasive fella in Saint-Denis. Anders, his name was. And he caught me at a bad time.
Oh, yeah?
Hell of a thing, right? It's that I'd been given over to some poor living, real poor living, kind of behavior the devil himself would be ashamed of. They promised me safety, salvation, paradise. All very appealing to a fella like me.
Carry on.
Got to the point where I'd given them every cent I had, and I was ready to follow them off a cliff. I just got out in time. Maybe it was the turtles, or maybe it was just I didn't have the spine to go through with it. All seems ridiculous now, looking back. The things we'll do for answers, huh? Anyway, sorry to ramble on. I should get back to it. You know, shit, you must have one of them familiar faces.
Come here.
This ain't good.
This ain't my business. Bye.
That's it. Come on. You're almost done. Oh, come here. Don't fight too much. Give up already. You're mine. Look at you. Yes. Smallmouth. I can't put you back. Okay, my girl.
Just a looker, neither. Watch this.
Hey, that's don't
relax.
Do that.
Jesus Christ! Oh, God damn it!
Are you okay? That don't look good.
It's fine.
It ain't fine.
Walk this
I see you're bleeding.
Will you quit hassling me and leave me be?
Don't forget that.
You might want to go to a doctor before heading to the saloon.
I'm fine. I'm fine.
Line up, Strawberry.
Hey, Cat.
What the hell?
Hey,
you cracked in the
kitty.
Head or something?
Hi there, kitty. Okay there?
Good morning.
You remind me of a feller I used to know.
Mm-hmm. You mind your business, I'll mind mine. Anyway, how's it all going for you? Okay, well, don't let me keep you.
Morning, sir.
Y'all doing all right?
Oh.
All the best now.
Bye.
Oh, do you have the time there?
Don't know.
Okay, thanks anyway.
Bye then.
Hello. I don't think I gave a receipt last time, did I? Let me do that right now. So, do you want this?
So, what are we looking at?
This is a big one. Armored bank and coach heading into Strawberry. You'll probably need something to blow the doors.
All right. Good seeing you, Hector.
I saw a picture of this city back east. They got these buildings taller than mine.
Stay.
Reaper. You don't want nobody seeing your face?
Thank you. that mask is giving me the shivers. Whoa! You don't need a gun to deal with me.
Hand over your money, mister.
I don't have much, but here.
That damn fool.
Get the law.
Hey, there's a bad guy
there.
Yeah.
Sure, we'll handle things. Get ready to fire at any moment now.
Yep.
Stop there! Keep your gun on him.
Hope you're planning on passing through here without any trouble. Scram, okay? Why don't you just leave?
Out of the way!
You want to see what
Hand over all your money, big man. Right now!
Damn you! Take it then.
Stop trying to play tough. Take it, please.
Okay, head on in. Tent to your left.
Tell you a morality tale from when our country was young, that the settlers used to tell about the woods of Massachusetts and the creatures that lived there. One summer, a bear was by the stream, and Old Man Wind appeared and said, "Bear, I shall blow a mighty cold upon the land. Engorge yourself on fish and meat and go find a den. Then sleep, not for one night, but for 60. Go tell all the animals of the forest what I have told you." Bear was sad because the fish were his friends, and now he had to eat them. But he knew to do whatever the wind told him. The animals of the forest often teased Bear and said he was slow and lazy and foolish for listening to Old Man Wind. "You're talking to the wind again, eh?" laughed the rabbit. "I think Bear has finally taken leave of his senses," said the turtle. "And he's getting so rotund that even I could outrun him." "I'm smart and quick," said Rabbit. "I'll outrun Old Man Wind if he comes a-calling, or you, since you're into eating your friends." The turtle said, "If Wind comes, I'll just hide in my shell." Then Bear went and warned Coyote and Possum that they should prepare for a long, cold winter. "It's so hot," said the coyote. "There's plenty of time." The lazy possum said, "Well, there's an abundance of food. Maybe I'll just store some in my pouch." Even his squirrel friends made fun of Bear. They laughed and laughed and squibbled and squabbled. "Chunky needs a nap. Fatty Goody Two-Shoes does what he's told." Bear was very sad, but he was a good bear, and he always did what Old Man Wind told him. He went and found a den, snuggled inside, and fell fast asleep. Bear snored and snored for many days. When he woke up, he saw spring had come. He was very hungry, so he walked outside. As the snow melted, he saw all his friends who hadn't listened frozen and just ready to be eaten. And that's why the bear hibernates. So listen to your elders and do just what you're told.
Hey there, partner.
Possessed you to put that on?
Nothing for you to concern yourself with. Anyhow, how are you doing?
Well.
All right, well, don't let me keep you.
All right, goodbye.
nice and easy.
Oh!
I've seen clowns look less an idiot than you.
fight too much. Damn, that's you. All right. I love catfish.
Mister?
Hello.